For every object in creation, IIV executes. For every object in creation, IIV will be executing, no matter which constructor you are using to create an object. No matter which constructor you are using to create an object. It can be the first constructor or it can be the second constructor. No matter for which constructor you are creating an object. By using which constructor you are creating an object, IIV will be executing. This we have seen yesterday also. IIV, it is only for executing some common code which is required for every object creation. IIV, it is for a common code. It is for a common code which is required for every object creation. For every object creation, if you want to execute a common code, there is some common code. For every object creation, it is required. Then instead of keeping in every constructor, instead of keeping in every constructor, you can keep in the IIB. IIBs are guaranteed to execute for every object of creation. IIBs are executing for every object of creation. If multiple constructors are there and there is a common code for every object of creation, there is a common code for every object of creation. Common code for every object of creation. In that scenario, IIB. IIBs are executing for every object of creation, no matter which constructor you are using. One more thing. IIB executes only one time for one object of creation. IIB executes only one time for one object of creation. IIB execution is only one time for one object of creation. IIB will not be executing more than one time for the same object of creation. IIB is not executing more than one time for the same object of creation. IIB execution only one time for one object of creation. IIB execution is object wise. Yesterday we have seen this calling statement. Thank you. Compile and run. So observe what are the output, what are the statements for every object creation. For some objects, even though two constructors are involving, IAB execution is one time only. IAB not executing more than one time. IIB execution is only one time, not more than one time. For every object creation, IIB executes only one time, even though multiple constructors are executing for the same object. No matter how many constructors are executing, even though guys even though multiple constructors are executing for the same object creation, IAB got executed only one time. For every object creation, IAB got executed only one time. IAB not executing more than one time for the same object creation. IAB execution is object wise, not the constructor wise. IAB execution is object wise, not the constructor wise. Even though multiple constructors are executing for the same object creation, even though multiple constructors are executing for the same object creation, understood? IAB execution is object wise. For one object, IAB executes only one time. It won't execute more than one time. Even though two constructors are involving while one object is creating, IAB execution is only one time. IAB execution is only one time. We are keeping IAB, guys. IAB constructor SIB. SIP will be executing only one time whenever class is loading to the memory. Constructor and IIN executing again and again whenever objects are created. Check it out, SIB, IIB, construct, all three are involved in the same program. Whenever class is loading to the memory, at that time SIB, SIB executing only one time for entire execution, IIB executing for every object creation. Come to the next one. How many objects he created to a particular class? How to identify total number of objects he creation to the same class? This is very important. Identifying how many number of objects he created to a particular class. Say this as a F dot Java. For every object creation, constructor executing, we are incrementing a counter. Counter is a static, it is not a non-static. If it is a static, it won't load to the memory while object is creating. It will be loading to the memory whenever class is loading to the memory. Whenever class is loading to the memory, In order to find out how many objects created to a particular class, use one static counter, increment the same in the constructor body. Static member means it will be loading to the memory only one time whenever class is loading. It is not loading to the memory for every object creation. It's not loading to the memory for every object creation. Yes or no? For every object creation, only non-static members will be loaded. Initially, counter is loading to the memory and storing in the memory with the default value 0. While object is creating, constructor is executing, 0 is becoming 1. While creating a second object, same counter incrementing from 1 to 2. While creating a third object, same counter. New counter is not loading to the memory as it is a static member. Static members are loading to the memory while loading a class itself. Come to the next one, guys. Come to the G class. I'm keeping three constructors. Totally three constructors are there. You can use any constructor to create an object. Object creation can be by using any constructor. G class containing totally three constructors. You can use any constructor to create an object. No matter which constructor you are using, it's one and the same of previous program. But in the previous program, there was only one constructor. We were able to create an object to F class by using only NoRP constructor. What about in the G class? How many constructors are there? 6 constructors. Constructor got overloaded perfectly 3 times. In every constructor body, we are keeping a counter +++. Customer can use first constructor to create any number of objects. Other customer can use second constructor to create any number of objects. Third one, any number of objects. G.com. So what is the output of this program? Now, how to reduce development of G-class? Whatever common code is there in every constructor, that code you can extract into IID. Same code we can develop in very easiest way. Whatever common code is there in the constructors that you can take out. Common code in all the constructors. Common code in every constructor give the IID. IIDs are executing for every object creation. IIDs are executing for every object creation. Find out what could be the output. Now you can see the exact requirement of IIBs. What we are achieving through IIBs. If any common code is there in every constructor, if any common code, if you want to execute something for every object creation, then use IIBs. For every object creation, counter has to increment. Keeping that counter increment in the IIB, keeping counter increment in the IIB. Copy the same. For every object creation, IIB executing only one time, not more than one time. So try to incorporate this calling statements also. keep an eye, one SOP in the IIB also. Please go through statement by statement. IIBs are used for executing any common execution for every object creation. Thank you. Importance of IIT. Now develop the same type of other program, J class. Make static as, make counter as a non-static conductor. Non-static and call OBJ 1 dot counter, OBJ 2 dot counter, OBJ 3 dot counter. J class. Make counter as a non-static. Let's call ourselves. Create three objects, call counter by using every reference level. Try to develop by yourself. Thank you. What is the observation? Not audible? Why always one? Any reason? I'm unable to see. Who is there? Please raise your hand. Come on, no problem. I want to see that person. Good. Excellent. class This time, counter is a non-static. You cannot use through class T. Non-static member always, you have to access by using reference variable, not by using class T. If you keep J, you get compiled time error. Go for OBJ 1. Counter is a non-static. Non-static not loading while class is loading. Non-static loading while object is creating. While object is creating, counter is starting with 0. Counter is starting with 0 in the IID. Counter is incrementing to 1. For every object creation, IIV executes only one time. Even though multiple constructors are executing, IIVs will execute only one time, not more than one time. You can see the clear difference between I output and J output. Let me run I. While running I, we are getting a final output as a 3. While running J. Counter is a part of the object now. First object, counter starting with 0 through IIV becoming 1. For second object, again a new counter loading into the memory starting with 0 through IIV becoming 1. Third one. For third object, again counter is starting with 0. Counter is starting with 0, becoming a 1. 1, 1, 1. Understood? IIV is executing only one time for one object creation, even though multiple constructors are executed. So we have seen very clearly, non-static members cannot be used without a reference variable. You should use along with the reference variable. What about static members? Current class static member, you can use straight away, or you can use along with the class name, or even you can use along with the reference variable also. There are three ways of using static members if it is in the same class. Let's see. I can use exist straight away. I can use k dot x. Even by using k1 also. Static members you can use any way, not only in the main method not only the constructor or SIV or IIV or non-static memory. No need of worrying about usage of static member just because of static members are loading to the memory while class loading itself. Because of static members loading to the memory while loading a class itself, you can able to use static member anywhere. If you are using current class static member, there are three ways. You can use static member straight away or along with the class name or even along with the reference variable. In general, static members, in general, static members we supposed to use along with the class name, as static members are loading to the memory while loading a class. We can consider static members are class members. While loading a class, static members are loading. To use the static member, use along with the class name. If it is current class, then class name also optional. If it is a current class, class name also optional. While using along with the reference variable, compiler, while compiling, it replaces from reference variable to class name. This is very important. While using static member along with the reference variable, k1.x, k1 is a reference variable. You have to use k1 only to use a non-static member. If at all you are using k1 to use static member, compiler will be replacing from reference variable to class name by compiling. This point also very important, you have to remember forever. I repeat one more time, static members we supposed to use along with the class name. If at all you are using along with the reference variable, compiler replaces from reference variable to class name inside a class file while generating a binary code. While generating a binary code, you will be getting a k.dot class. Inside a k.dot class, the last SOP will be SOP of k.x, not the k1.x. Compiler generating a binary code for SOP of k.x. SOP of k.x.
Compiler won't modify anything in the Java file. Compiler not keeping default constructor in the Java file. Compiler keeping a default constructor in the class file only. Whatever additional code, whatever modified code that it is incorporating in the class file, not in the Java file. Assume K class. It doesn't have any constructors. We didn't develop any constructor. But every class should have a minimum one constructor. No matter whether you are creating an object or not, every class should have a minimum one constructor. We didn't develop. Compiler only incorporating default constructor, that is an org constructor. But it is not incorporating in our Java file. We developed a Java file. Compiler developing a class file. In the class file, compiler keeping a default constructor. Got it, Atma? Default constructor. Very similarly, SOP of k1.x while compiling, it is generating a binary code to SOP of k.x. In the class file, it is modifying from SOP of k1.x to SOP of k.x. Static members, you can consider as a universal members. In any member of a class, we can use static member. In the IIP also, we can use static method. In the constructor body, in the static method, in the non-static method, anywhere we can use static members. Static members considered as a universal members. Any confusion? So you can compile this successfully. While running, you'll be getting 3 zeros. Body. So practice all these examples. We'll continue tomorrow.